Hello friends, welcome to Mechanical Engineering online classes.
So let us solve a problem on balancing of reciprocating masses. The question is, a single cylinder reciprocating engine runs at 300 rpm and it is having a stroke length 250 mm. The mass of reciprocating parts is 40 kg and the mass of revolving part is 28 kg, which is at 125 mm radius. If only 2/3 of the reciprocating part and all the revolving part are to be balanced, then we have to find the balancing mass that is required at a radius of 350 mm and also the resultant, that is a residual unbalanced force, Fr. In magnitude and direction, when the crank has turned 45 from IDC, 45 from IDC means here also the crank is rotating in and in clockwise direction. So let us first take down the given data. The given data is that speed is given n, which is 300 rpm. All our formulas are in terms of omega, so we have to find omega from given n, which is 2 pi n by 60. So 2 pi into 300 by 60. So on calculating this, we get 31.4159 radian per second. And stroke length is also given. Stroke length means the maximum distance that the piston can move. The maximum distance the piston can move is this diameter, IDC to ODC, because the crank pin, the C point, can be first at IDC and again its another extreme point is ODC. So this IDC to ODC will be R plus R, where R is the length of crank. So the length of stroke capital L will be equal to 2R. So given stroke length L, so in terms of small r we have to find in terms of length of crank, which is 250 mm or 0.25 meter. So from this, R is equal to 0.25 meter by 2, which will be 0.125 meter. Now, the mass of reciprocating part is 40 kg. So, M is equal to 40 kg. And the mass of revolving part, which is M1. In the previous formula, we have seen M1 is 28 kg. 28 kg is given, this one. And only 2/3 of the reciprocating mass should be balanced. So, that C is equal to 2 by 3, 0.67. And we are supposed to find MB when the balancing mass required at a radius of 350 mm. So RB is given. RB is given as 350 mm or nothing but 0.35 meter. And we have to find all the unknowns, which is MB or FR, when theta is 45. So theta is equal to 45 degrees. We have to find first one MB, then FR. FR's magnitude and direction both are asked. Magnitude and direction, we are supposed to find these things. So let us start solving the problem. We know that when mass of rotating part and also reciprocating part and also the revolving part, if both should be balanced, then MBRB is given by CMR plus M1R. MBRB is equal to MR into C plus M1R. Now here the question is that we have to find a balancing mass only to partially balance the reciprocating mass. This is the reciprocating mass. Partially balancing is, he told only 2/3 should be balanced. And that all the revolving mass, which is M1, should be balanced. So here it is not asked, find only one third of something or 1/4 of revolving mass. No, he told all the revolving mass. So M1R is M1R only. We don't multiply it with any fraction. And balancing of revolving masses doesn't require partial balancing. We can fully balance them. More or less fully it can be balanced. So here it is m1r only. So mb is the only unknown. We have to find this mb. And rb is given. In the given data we have rb, which is 0.35. This is equal to m is given as 40 into r is given as 0.125. This one, this is r. We have calculated that from the stroke length. Into c is 2 by 3 plus mass of revolving part is given as 28 kilogram, which is again at r, which is nothing but 0.125. So if we calculate, the only unknown in this is mb. So mb is equal to 40 into 0.125 into 2 by 3 plus 28 into 0.125, the whole is divided by 0.35, and we get MB as 19.5238 kg. So we have found the balancing mass. First step is over. Now we have to find FR. Step 2, let us find the resultant unbalanced force, which is FR. We know that FR is nothing but FH square plus FV square, or that is nothing but we know FH. FH is nothing but 1 minus C into MR omega square cos theta. This is FH, and this is FV, MRC omega square sin theta. So let us write these formulae there. So because FH is nothing but 1 minus C into MR omega square cos theta, so this is nothing but 1 minus C is given as 2 by 3. 2 by 3 into mass is 40, which is M, into 0.125 into omega is calculated. And we obtained omega as 31.4159. So it is 31.4159 square into cos theta. Theta is 45. So we have to calculate FH now, which comes out to be 1163.142 newton. So this is FH. Similarly, we have to find FV. FV can be given as MR omega square into C into sine theta. This is nothing but 40 into 0.125 into 31.4159 square into 2 by 3 sine 45. So this comes out to be 2326.2841 newton. Now, because we know FV and FH, we can find the resultant magnitude. The magnitude of resultant can be given as root over FV square plus FH square. So this will come out to be 2600.8647 newtons. So here we have calculated the magnitude of the resultant unbalanced force. But the question, it is asked to find resultant unbalanced force in magnitude and direction also. So we have calculated magnitude, we have to calculate the direction. So in case our unbalanced force Fr is somehow, if Fv is this, Fh is this, let our resultant be somewhere here. So we have to find the angle. Let alpha be the angle that it makes, that the Fr makes with respect to some horizontal. So we can find tan alpha as Fv by Fh. We are just trying to find the slope. M is equal to tan theta means y by x, like that. So Fv is 2326.2841 and Fh is 1163.142. So alpha is tan inverse of around 2. So tan inverse 2 will be 63.4349 degrees. So we get the direction of the resultant unbalanced force. So here completes our problem.
Thanks for watching. If this video was of help to you, please like it and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel.